cause the next song I said, yeah, the next song I said, I'm just proud of my accomplishments. I'm a 400, I don't care at all. For all your kids and bro, they straight, you shouldn't care at all.
Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always leave.
Yeah, 104 times how I go down. Slaps on deck for the whole town. On mamas, man, I did it with my own sound. And I got my own city that I hold down. Just admit it already. You got plans to do it, boy, we did it already. Got a couple DMs, I done slid in already. Gotta ask YG if he hit it already. Yeah, I'm a star like Moesha's. Running up the numbers like Aisha's. Yeah, I be sliding, I be creeping. Girls these days, they just don't know how to keep it. But I got it all handled. They try to box me and I got my own angles, yeah. I'ma spend the summer getting to the cake and I'ma wishing put on every candle. I'm like,
please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Why you wait?
Please tell me why you always leave. Please tell me why you always leave.
Know me, but you know now.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. Opening week in the NFL is an exciting time for everybody, including these two teams here today. It's the Falcons going up against the Raiders. The opening kick of the new season is straight ahead as we turn it over to our broadcast duo of Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, after an off-season of questions, football is back here in the East Bay in Oakland, California. Today, it's the opener of a new NFL season between the Atlanta Falcons and the Oakland Raiders. Setback. On first and 10, here's Carr. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Offensive starters now. Charles, what about Latavius Murray?
You know how you and I talk about players under the radar sometimes? Latavius Murray definitely qualifies as one of those players. And then you look up and he's pressing 1,000 yards every year.
Second down, and he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by the all-pro corner, Josh Norman, and his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
Throwing left side here, and it's complete. Now a loose football. The ball comes out.
I don't know about you, but I could hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. Ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession. No turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. And the quarterback, he's got some big threats at wideout.
And they seem to get bigger all the time, don't they, Brandon? Every time I look out and watch a game, we're getting these bigger, more athletic, acrobatic receivers. We have some today.
Watch it now, Barney. Barney. Check.
Now the first carry for Matt Jones. Just a couple on the ground there, and that's going to bring up third and about six. Time to meet the defensive starters for the Oakland Raiders, and you want to discuss one of their safeties.
I certainly do. Carl Joseph out of West Virginia always did a great job policing the middle of the field. A big hitter, knocked the ball away, but really added to his game his last year as a Mountaineer. Became a better cover guy and a better ball hawk before he got injured. They're really going to love him in Oakland.
On third down, here's Jones. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. So out now comes the field goal unit for the Falcons. This is a 26-yard attempt. And Parkey's kick is good. And the Falcons are out to a 3-0 advantage. So our initial drive here this afternoon results in three. I'm not sure that was a statement necessarily, but getting points on the road, never a bad thing.
No question about it, Brandon. You had a crowd that was all fired up during pregame introductions, yet you're able to quiet them just a little bit by taking the early lead.
And now Oakland ready to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
Here we go. Wide and eight. Wide.
Now a first carry for Latavius Murray. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight. Carter, your thoughts on this D-line?
I love a unit that can control the run and get after the passer. This is an all-around terrific defensive front. Hard to move the ball against them on the ground, and then when you want to throw it, look out. Here they come after the quarterback.
See if they stay on the ground for second down.
Four down. We ready? Red, 18.
Shotgun now for Carr. And he will find his man on the outside. It goes as a gain of eight, and it moves the chains.
What's fun to watch is these college receivers transitioning into the NFL and how they grow as route runners. Because a lot of times now in the college game, the spread offenses, there aren't that many routes that they're actually running. Most of the time, they're just trying to find open space and present themselves to the quarterback as easy targets. But in the NFL, you've got to run the entire route tree, and you've got to run it well if you expect to get open.
Murray, the lone setback. They go play action here on first down. And this is Shepard on the catch. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Love the call by the offensive coordinator, recognizing the situation very well, calling for the play action pass, and completing it.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Down, Murray. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43. Vic Beasley able to make the tackle.
A 1 yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1 yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1 yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Now Carr throwing on second down. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field and it's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
And defensively, it's a nickel formation here on third down and nine. Throwing his car on third down. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And 21 yards there as they convert on third.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And now a first down following that long gain. They come up in an offset eye. Now here's the first carry for Amir Abdullah. And not much running room. Down to the 32. Calling a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Today's NFL, you hear all the time about stretching the field and creating space in order to run plays. A toss play will help accomplish that because now you're pushing a defense to chase you all the way to the edges and to the sideline. That's a nice run. Probing now early to try and get things done later.
Now Carr. No, he almost had it. Already with one interception, just missing his second there. Well, he just threw an interception last drive, nearly another pick.
And things aren't very even right now, are they? It's a little bit sloppy out there, isn't it? It's kind of the difference between driving on those paved roads and those country roads that have those potholes in them, isn't it? Because that's the way this game's going right now. A lot of bouncity bounce to it.
You spent some time on some Tennessee country roads.
I certainly have. Plenty of family back there. God love them.
All right, here we go. Red 18. Red 18. Here we go, rally. Rally.
From the gun now on third down, Carr. He completes it to Boyd. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25.
That was a nice completion on an out route, and those types of plays are the result of arm strength by the quarterback and timing by the receiver.
Now this will be the ninth play on this drive. They'll come out in the pistol. Back to the ground game. Here's Murray. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. They'll run again. This time it's Abdullah. And he'll get this down only to the 18. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a 3rd down and 2.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense, and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock. You control the ball. And that way, you often control the game.
And this defense looks for one more stop here on 3rd after the run. Looking to throw on 3rd and 2. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Latavius Murray from 17 yards out. And the Raiders have taken the early lead. So on 3rd and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
All right, here we go.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but they have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks. Those guys are worth their weight in gold.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number 2.
Flashback.
They'll look to throw here on first down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. That throw good for four. It's second down.
What terrifies defenses when they see slant routes thrown is that the receiver is on the move, and oftentimes he catches it and gets upfield. Does a really nice job rallying to him and stopping it for a minimal gain.
Back to throw here. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about five or six plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Matt Jones, a 22-yard touchdown grab, and the Falcons have retaken the lead. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And his throw here is incomplete. They were trying to get it there to Sterling Shepard. And now it's second down. They go play action for Murray. Now Carr going up top. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended target. And it's third down.
I know the initial focus was on how far that pass was downfield, but how about the coverage on the play? Able to stay with him, get his hands where the receiver's hands were going to try and catch the ball, tips it up in the air, and knocks it away.
So a ways to go here on third and 10. One receiver to the left is Cooper.
All right, here we go. Wide and yay. Wide and yay. 54 is Mike. 54 is Mike. Check, check. Watch 54. Watch 54.
From the gun, it's Carr. It's caught. Shepard. And he's brought down after a good game. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered. But how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I will hear about that from him soon.
Take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Second down following the run. Play action. It's Carr. He's got time in the pocket. Trying to lay one up deep. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position. Couldn't hold on. Third down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. So third and seven, and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
Throwing his car on third down. And he'll have his man. That's Cooper. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. Call it a pickup of seven, and that's going to make it fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
Man, confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. Nine yards still remaining here to pick up the first on second down. One receiver left, three to the right. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And it's a fumble, and his guys are going to get the football at the 23. Start this drive with very good field position. So after the fumble recovery, it's Carr. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And he goes out of bounds inside the 10 at the 9. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. Try to run it in with Murray. And finding room to work, he's down to the 2-yard line. That's a gain of seven, and we'll leave them with second and goal coming up.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes, and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
They come out here in the eye. Now they'll run. Murray. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Latavius Murray. Already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Raiders have retaken the lead. And that makes it 14-10. The Raider kickoff unit now as they will send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. They give them 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Now a play fake here on first down. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. It's a pickup of 33 yards, and that leads to an Atlanta first down. From from the shotgun. He'll look to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. That throw good for four. It's second down. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We'll come back to Oakland after this. And they're definitely showing blitz here.
Let's go! 3-19! 3-19!
Back to throw again. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps. He cuts towards the middle of the field, and now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
Down here in the red zone, you know your tight end's going to be a favorite target. Couldn't hang on.
And sometimes they just have to get out of their own head because they understand how tight windows are there and how many bodies are there. And sometimes they just overthink it and don't catch the ball.
That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Throw on third and goal, and he dropped it. Now it was tipped, altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it, and now fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And Parkey's kick is good, and the lead is down to one now at 14-13. So the drive takes him inside the 10, but it ends with just three.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get in.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield.
He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. So out come the Falcons now. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
This will be caught at about the 3. They got 29 yards there. And the Falcons are going to have a first and goal. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Marvin right now is just tallying it up.
And he will take it in for a Falcon touchdown. Matt Jones, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Falcons have once again taken the lead. And that'll make this a 6-point game. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time, do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down, they're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot.
And he will not get away from the pressure here. Carr taken down.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through.
Never mind, Larry. Forget your halftime report. Apparently, we are set for the third quarter of action already. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try to stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. He's going to loft one deep left side here. That's caught inside the 20. It's a big play there for Atlanta. 44 yards. And I guess, Charles, sometimes when you have a receiver well over 6 foot, you do that. Just put it up there, let him grab it, and he did.
And it certainly appears like a 50-50 ball, right? We always talk about that when both sides have a chance to get it, the receiver or the guy covering him. But I think the odds actually are in favor of the offense. They can see the ball coming oftentimes before the defender can get his head around. So I think that really goes to like 70-30, and they should be able to go up and get it most of the time.
He got it there. They come out with one back and three tight ends. And the offense inside the... And he gets in. Touchdown, Atlanta. Matt Jones with now 3 week 1 touchdowns. And the Falcons will extend their lead. So he's in for his third score of the game. And defense probably saying, man, we don't want to see this guy for a long time.
It's bad enough when anyone scores a touchdown against you. But for one person to get three... It almost sets him apart from the rest of the game, and no one likes to see any of those players on a pedestal, not from the defensive point of view.
And he's going to be taken down. It's a sack, and they fail on the try for two. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half?
Because no, tell me.
That's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker boards?
Yeah, those two.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. One receiver to the left is Cooper.
All right, here we go. Red 18. Red 18, baby. Alert.
Now Carr throwing on second down. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
On first down, Carr. It's hauled in by Shepard, and he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. He had time, was able to survey the field, and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field that you have to cover, and when the offense finds an area that you're not in, that's where they throw the football.
They go play action here on first down. Oh, man, it's caught inside the 10. It's a gain of 24 that time. And the Raiders are going to have a first and goal. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver with his first career touchdown in his first career game. And the Raiders have cut it back to within a score. And this is back to a five-point game. A five-point game now as here comes the kickoff. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll probably wish he reconsidered here. It'll cost him 10 yards now with a new rule as he's down at the 15-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. Try and start this drive in the air. And caught by Cameron right side. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. On the give, this is their fullback. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
Let's face it, you always want a team full of guys who can get you first downs and big plays of all styles, but you've got to have a big man. You can just turn and hand it to, and he can be dependable in picking up first downs.
So the offense has it first and 10. To the ground, this time with Jones. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense, and guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Now back to throw. It's caught by Clive Walford. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. So an excellent throw and an excellent catch there.
Zone coverage, which means you just have to find the open areas in between defenders, is exactly what happened on that play.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Here we go now. Barney, Barney.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to loft one deep. He's got it. Hit the 15. A big time play there for the Falcons. 42 yards. Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day. You know, when we get together this year and the Davises and the Gardens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like they're drawing them up in the dirt. And so far, it's working for both of them.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. That time, they hit him out of the slot on the drag.
And that route takes some fortitude from the guy running it because he knows he's going through the briar patch, as I like to call it, right? He's trying to work his way through all that traffic and people wanting to put a little contact on it. Really well done.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Play number seven now coming up on the drive. Third and five. One man in the backfield. That's Jones. Again, he'll drop to throw. Oh, it's a touchdown if he holds on. Instead, it's fourth down. Now, they've got to be a little frustrated here to not complete that on third down after having such a long drive going.
Hey, you talked about going over 70 yards on the drive. Yeah, did you say a little frustrated?
Very frustrated.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. I'm very frustrated. There's no doubt about it. They thought they were going to have a chance to cash in the end zone. Now it looks like it's likely a field goal attempt.
So three field goals for him here, and this last one helps him stretch out the lead.
And he's been solid as usual. And this is what you need to do. Make sure you get points out of every possession. And so far, they've done a nice job of that.
It'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Now the Oakland offense heading back onto the field to take over. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now, they're just cutting them to shreds.
Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Back now in the East Bay. It's Raider football here, but they're on the short side of the scoreboard right now as we begin. And a long way to go for the offense here on second down. From the gun, it's Carr. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. A great read, and it's picked off. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Finding time. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Their big-bodied receiver, a 24-yard touchdown. And the Falcons use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. And the lead is up to 15 now. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. The Raider offense now making their way toward the huddle. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Yeah, coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
And complete to Zach Ertz. Give him nine there on the first down completion. And quickly, they get to the line.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Carnell on first down. Ertz has it left side. The completion good for three, and it's second down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Amari Cooper, his intended receiver, and that takes us from second to third down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
Red 18. Red 18. Here we go. Rally.
Throwing his car on third down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And they're going to speed things up here.
Here we go. 5 and 8. 5 and 8.
Carnell on first down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch.
Hey. All right, here we go. Red 18.
Now a play fake here on first down. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out. Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10.
Patrick! Hurry up, here we go. Blue liner!
A give to Jones. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard. He's brought down that time by a couple of Raiders.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They'll set up a throw. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 15 yards there on the catch and run. And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
Running right, Jones. And a cut to the sideline. Touchdown, Falcons! And let's not forget he had the receiving touchdown earlier. Now a trio of rushing touchdowns. Quite a performance.
Diversification, that's all you can talk about. His ability to do everything leaves him on the field on every down on offense because you can hand it to him, as we've seen. But you said 3 rushing touchdowns, and of course throw it to him where he's caught 1 as well.
Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And last year, that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year, he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee. And that's at the 25. The Raiders offense now making their way back out onto the field. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Murray, the lone setback. Carr, wide open, Amari Cooper. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. So Amari Cooper out of Northwestern High School in Miami making a nice play there.
And it's so funny that when I was going through the draft process when he came out of Alabama, and was inquiring about him and his skills. They say it all began back in Miami. He really became a pro receiver at a young age because of his attention to detail and precision. And don't forget his athletic ability. That's what made that catch there.
He did spend 1 year with Teddy Bridgewater as his quarterback there, so that helped back in high school. And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line.
We just saw him hit a big play there on a deep post. And most of the time, the post isn't available because usually you have defenders in the middle of the field. But if you throw enough curls and crossing routes and underneath routes, I know from experience, they get tired of watching those balls get caught. They start to creep up a little bit, and that's when you can hit them big over the top.
Only 2 yards on the completion at second down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
It's Carr. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking to get it into his receiver, Cooper, and that'll make it third down.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense, but in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass, excellent job, way to knock it down.
They'll run for it. This is Murray. Call it no gain on the play, so no help there. And now fourth and goal. Big boys down there in the trenches and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you're talking about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
And here just playing for pride at this point. Down big, but they'll go for it on fourth and goal. Now Carr, gotta have this one. And it is incomplete. They can't hook up here on the fourth down pass attempt. And the Falcons defense stands tall. They'll get the football back. And here now come the Falcons. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now, to put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there. But we all know the guy carrying the ball is going to get the credit, both in the stat line and probably in the newspaper. But guess what? Those guys creating holes, they couldn't feel better about themselves right now. Offensive line, tight end, probably even the wide receivers are involved. They're moving the ball well.
And this looks to probably be the final play. And partner, this first week, this first game that we get to call together, so special every year, week one. You had the flyover, the big American flag out there before the game, all the hoopla, just having football back, so special.
It is an opening day, opening game. There's just nothing like it because you really build to a crescendo. But the best part for us is that crescendo lasts for a while. Opening game here, an entire season. We get into the playoffs, to the Super Bowl. I was really excited. I could barely